The city of Raleigh has 8,800 registered voters. There are two candidates for city council in an upcoming election, Brown and Felice. The day before the election, a telephone poll of 600 randomly selected registered voters was conducted. 331 said they'd vote for Brown, 251 said they'd vote for Felice, and 18 were undecided. We're asked to give the sample statistic for the proportion of voters surveyed who said they'd vote for Brown. Note the proportion should be a fraction or decimal, but not a percent. So of the 600 randomly selected registered voters, 331 said they'd vote for Brown. And therefore, the proportion of voters surveyed who said they'd vote for Brown would be 331 out of 600, which gives us the fraction 331 over 600. This fraction doesn't simplify, so we can leave it in this form. If we click Preview, we can see the fraction expresses a decimal. Next, this sample statistic suggests that we might expect how many of the 8,800 registered voters to vote for Brown. So there are several ways to solve this problem. One way would be to pose the question, what is 331/600 of the total registered voters, which is 8,800? Of means multiply, so to find this fraction of 8,800, we would have 331 over 600 times 8,800. Let's find this product on the calculator, and we'll also answer this question a different way. So let's put our fraction of 331 over 600 in parentheses, and then we have times 8,800. Now we're going to round to the nearest voter or nearest whole number, so we'll round this to 4,855 voters. But notice how it does come out to approximately 4,854.67. But again, for our answer, because we're talking about voters, we'll round to the nearest whole number, which would be 4,855. But let's also set this up a different way by using a proportion. Let's let x be equal to the number of registered voters expected to vote for Brown, and now let's set this up as a proportion. Using our sample statistic, we know that 331 voters out of 600 will vote for Brown, and this should be equal to the number of registered voters expected to vote for Brown, which would be x, out of the total number of voters, which is 8,800. And now that we have a proportion, we can cross multiply and solve for x, meaning 600 times x must equal 331 times 8,800. So again, 600x must equal 331 times 8,800, which is equal to 2,912,800. And now to solve for x, we would divide both sides by 600. So we'll have x is approximately equal to this quotient here, which should give us the same answer. So 2,912,800 divided by 600. Notice how it does give us the same result of approximately 4,854.67. Which of course rounded to the nearest whole number or nearest voter gives us the same result. So here are two methods to determine how many of the registered voters we would expect to vote for Brown. I hope you found this helpful.